click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hey friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the molecular orbital diagram for the carbon molecule, and similarly we are going to talk about on that theory, we are going to talk about how can we represent the molecular orbital diagram for nitrogen molecule. So let us talk about it. So now here we are going to talk about the molecular orbital diagram for the nitrogen molecule. But before that we should understand that how can we represent the atomic orbital for the nitrogen atom, as well as how can we write the electronic configuration for nitrogen. So nitrogen has an atomic number of 7, so that could be represented as basically 1s2, 2s2 and 2p3. So now let me represent the orbital. That is for s orbital there is basically 1 orbital, for p subshell basically there is 3 orbitals, namely as px, py and pz, that is what we know. And now let us fulfill the electrons over here. So I would fulfill the electrons because the s subshell consists of 2 electrons. So here also for s orbital there will be 2 electrons, and for px orbital there will be 1 electron, for py there will be 1, and for pz there will be 1 electron, making a total of, that is the p subshell consists of basically 3 electrons when it comes to 2p subshell. So that is what we have represented over here, and in this case basically we could easily say that basically everything unpaired electrons are been responsible for formation of bond, and that is what we have got over here, unlike that of the noble gases or that we have talked about, that is helium and neon. So now let us understand that how can we represent the atomic orbital for the nitrogen molecule. So this is the energy level diagram that I have represented just in case for giving the atomic orbital for nitrogen, as well as it can represent the molecular orbital for that of the nitrogen molecule. So talking about this thing, we have 3 levels that we have, that is the first is basically we know it as 1s orbital, the next is basically it is 2s orbital, and ultimately we have basically 2p orbital or 2p subshell. This is the energy level for that one, and again similarly we could represent for atomic orbitals for various energy levels, that is for 2s and this for 1s that we have. So now let us fulfill the orbitals over here. So therefore there will be 1 electron, 1 orbital will be over here, that is I am representing. So 1 is 2px, 1 is 2py, 1 is 2pz, here also 2px, 2py and 2pz. So this is what we have. So now let us represent the electrons over here. So this is what I am representing the atomic orbital for that is nitrogen atom. Even this is the atomic orbital for nitrogen atom. And now while fulfilling the electrons, so therefore there is 2 electrons over here, 2 electrons over here, and 1, 2, 3 electron. We write it in that way. So this is for px, this is for py and this is for pz. The designation is actually very important because it gives an idea that which of the orbital is responsible for giving a sigma bond, or which one of the orbital is responsible for giving a pi bond. So that's the reason it is very important, and that's what we designated in that way. So even here also we could write it as px, py and pz. So now let us fulfill the electrons. So even it will be similarly that what we have did for this atomic orbital, and this is what we have. So the thing that we know, that is obviously the 1s is responsible for giving a non-bonding orbital. So this is what we have over here. Again for this one there will be 2 energy levels. So this is what we have discussed in our previous lectures also. So each of it consisting of 1 orbital, that is what we can compare it with the normal energy level that we have. So this is the bonding orbital that we have, and this is the antibonding orbital, making a total of 4 electrons that we have in this 2s level, and that is how we fulfill the electrons. But talking about this 2p orbital, this is somewhere different compared to what we have learned earlier, because when we have talked about boron, when we have talked about carbon, and now we are going to talk about that is nitrogen. So similarly when it comes to boron, carbon and nitrogen, so the 2px and the 2py orbitals that they are responsible for forming a molecular orbital diagram, that is what we are representing over here. So during the molecular orbital, the 2px and the 2py, they are at the lower energy level, and talking about the 2pz, they are at the higher energy level, and that is what I am representing over here, and that is what we have represented in terms of boron and in terms of carbon, and that is what I am going to do. So 2 energy level will be in the bonding orbital, while the 2 energy level, that is what we could see in the antibonding orbital. While talking about here, there will be 2px, 2py, there will be 2pz, Here will be 2px, 2py, and here will be 2pz. So therefore, this is how we can represent. Because obviously we could know that 2s and 2p orbital, they will have almost the similar energy. So now, because of it, they distribute themselves in such a manner. And that is what I'm representing over here. So this is what we can do. So now let us fulfill the electrons, and but before fulfilling the electrons, let us designate it. So for this one, this is responsible for known as pi 2px orbital, while this is known as pi 2py orbital, while this is known as sigma 2pz orbital, molecular orbital, that is what I am talking about, and this is basically pi star 2px orbital, while this is pi star 2py orbital, while this one is sigma star 2pz orbital. And now what we have is, we have basically 6 electrons in it in the 2p orbitals, including this 2p of one nitrogen and this 2p subshell of the other nitrogen, so making it a total of 6 electrons that we have. And how can we fill it? We can fulfill it with, according to the Abbas principle, as well as according to the Hund's multiplicity rule. So the lower energy level is basically the pi 2px compared to that of the 2pz, so therefore we are going to fulfill the electrons in the pi 2px first, and then we'll fulfill it in the sigma 2pz orbital or molecular orbital. So therefore, 1, and now we are applying Hund's rule, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is what we have fulfilled. So this is what we have represented the molecular orbital for, that is nitrogen molecule or N2 molecule, that is what we have got over here. And let me designate this also. So this was the one that was left. So this is sigma 2s, and this is sigma star 2s. And why always you could see that sigma has no pi, sigma has talking about this 2s orbital, this s orbital is responsible for forming sigma bond. That is because of the we know the shape of the s orbital, and that is spherical, and obviously they can collide in any way, and so as to form a good overlapping compared to that of the lateral overlapping of pz, or axial overlapping of pz, and lateral overlapping of px and py. So it has a characteristic shape that is spherical shape, and that is the reason it forms sigma bond. So let us come back to this one. So how can we represent the electronic configuration of the nitrogen molecule? So that is what we are concerned with. So talking about electronic configuration of nitrogen molecule, so we could say that it could be written as, that is k dot k, then we could say that is sigma 2s, which consists of 2 electrons, and later on sigma star 2s, which is also consists of 2 electrons, and then later on it will be pi 2p x, which consists of 2 electrons, and pi 2py, which consists of 2 electrons. So this is what we have represented over here, and again, yes, one thing has been left, that is sigma, that is 2pz, which consists of 2 electrons. So this is what we have represented over here for nitrogen molecule. And talking about the bond order, so the bond order, we know it as NB minus NA, which we have discussed in our previous lecture many times, and that is NB represents the electrons that are being present in the bonding orbital, while the NA represents the number of electrons that are being present in the antibonding orbital. So for a reference, suppose if we observe this diagram, so this is the bonding electron that we are not talking about this 2s, we are talking about the 2p orbital, 2p subshell, because that is the outermost subshell, and that's the reason that it is responsible for forming a bond. So we are concerned with that only. So here is basically 6 electrons that we have, and there is no electron that are present in the antibonding orbital, as we could see. So I could write it in this way, that is 6 minus 0 divided by 2, which is makes 3. So the bond order is basically 3, which indicates that the nitrogen and the nitrogen, the both of the nitrogen atom will have basically 3 bonds, and that is what we represent here. But there is something that I want to tell you. So if we observe here, that is, it is sigma 2pz that is responsible for giving a sigma bond, and the rest of it, that is pi 2px and pi 2py, that gives, that is pi bond. So that's the reason that among this, one bond will be responsible, one bond will be, that is a sigma bond, and that is because of the sigma 2pz orbital of both the nitrogen, and the rest of it is basically pi bond that we could observe over here. So this is, that is the bond between the two nitrogen atom and overall nitrogen molecule. So this is what we have got to discuss about the nitrogen molecule, and this is the diagram that we have got for molecular orbital diagram for nitrogen molecule. So not only the energy level that we have got over here, but we have also got to know about the bond order, as well as we have also got to know about the electronic configuration and various details about why the pi 2px and the pi 2py have lower energy compared to that of the 2pz orbitals. So this is what we have got to know in this lecture. So that's it, friend. That is what I want to talk about. So thank you, friends, for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you have understood this video very clearly. And I hope you will share this video with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.